Here, OKM Americas, we are today at the Reed Gold Mine, one of the most historic gold mines east of the Mississippi. It was, North Carolina was the number one gold producing state in the U.S. until 1848, when this little thing called the California Gold Rush happened. But what we're doing today is we're using the Rover C4 in mineral scan mode so that we're going to make some passes over the load gold that we know is still here in the Reed Gold Mine. And we're going to show you what that looks like, how to set up your mineral scan, and what it actually the results look like at the end so that you can identify when you've found load gold. Okay, guys, we're in the area where we're going to do our first scan. And if I back up a little bit, you can see the cone here. That's where we're going to start our first scan. And you can't see the second cone because it's over the crest of the hill. But we're going to be walking a straight line to that second cone. And, you know, as you know, in mineral scan, it's one straight line. So I've got the Rover C4 here. I've got the super sensor connected to it. It connects right here. And so I'm going to power this guy up. Now, one thing that I've already done that you haven't seen is we've gone over this with the magnetometer in magnetometer mode to make sure that the area is clean. That's something you always want to do whenever you're doing a mineral scan or a ground scan, is to make sure that your scan area doesn't have any debris on it, metal objects or anything, because that will definitely tend to affect your results. So that's always something you want to do first. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to walk over to the cone and then walk down to the second cone, and we're going to do our mineral scan. Now, one thing that's important is when you're holding the super sensor, you can see you've got the arrow on the top. You always want that pointing in the direction of travel, and you'd never want to rotate it. You always want to make sure that it's straight and on target with respect to your travel. Now, so, and I like to hold it between my fingers like this. It gives it a plumb bob effect so that you're, it's vertical, and that's when you get the best readings, is when it's vertical. Now, the cable on it is pretty long. I wrap that over my neck like this. So I've got the, I'll back up so that you can see it. I've got the control unit in my left hand, the sensor in my right hand. I'm going to walk over to my first cone, and we're going to make the first mineral scan. So we made our first scan. I have 124 impulses in that scan. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to go back and make a control scan, a second scan. And then when we get back to the, when we transfer these over to the laptop, we'll be able to determine if there were any anomalies or anything that would cause the two scans to not be consistent. And if we find that the two scans are not consistent, then I'll come back out and do a third scan. So this is the second scan, or the control scan. So to do that, I finalize this scan by pressing the back button, and it's finalized. So now I choose mineral scan again. I choose the memory slot here. I'm going to put it in the second memory slot there, and now I'm ready to go. I'm going to do it again. Go back to the main area, and we're going to upload this to the, transfer these to the laptop and see what we've got. Okay, so I go to file, I go to import, I choose the Rover C4, hit next, choose the OKM Rover C4 USB module, choose mineral scan, hit next, and you can see here the data is going to start transferring over to the laptop.
it.
And here we go. It's importing the file.
Hey guys, Mark here. We've made our field analysis at the Reed Gold Mine. Now it's time to go in and see what we found. So I've opened up our Visualizer 3D Studio, and I'm going to open the files that we had from the Reed Gold Mine. So here I've got our Reed Gold Mine folder. I'm going to the first file that we, showing the scan, the first scan that we made there. And here we see the scan. The first thing I like to do in the mineral scan mode when I'm analyzing the scans is go into visualization, which is here. That's the fifth tab down on the right-hand side. And I scroll all the way down to the bottom, and you see where it says soil type cross-section? I take that all the way to the left, so there's no cross-section that appears here. The second thing that I like to do is expand this scan, and you do that by rolling, by having your cursor in the field and then rolling your mouse pointer forward so that it your mouse wheel forward so that it extends the length. This, for me, this makes it a little bit easier to see those hits and hit. So now I've grabbed the scroll at the bottom and I'm moving it to the right, so that we can see where our, if there are any hits in the hits, and here I see it. So we have the hit in the hit that's right here. You see you've got your nice diamond shape here. You've got a very thin connector that comes off of the left side of that diamond shape, and then you've got the nice blue color that's coming off of it. So this is our hit in a hit, and you can see that it extends all the way to the left. So this is a fairly strong representation of a hit in a hit. And now you say, okay, that's great, but where is it? So the way you find it is you go in, you use the crosshairs on your, the arrows on your keyboard. And in this case, I'm moving the arrows to the right. And you can see the vertical crosshair is, the vertical line is in sight. And now it is directly on the hit in a hit. And I go here to the second button down, which is the scan information. And I look in this area here where it says crosshairs. And at this point, it tells me how many impulses there were. And it tells me at what impulse the crosshair is located. So it's impulse 29, and based on a distance of 51 feet that we measured in the field, we can see that this hit in a hit is 23.41 feet from the beginning. So in order to find this, I would go back to the beginning and measure 23.41 feet down the line that we walked, and that's where we would do the core drill in order to identify the load gold, find the load gold in that area. So super exciting. I have to admit, it's Reed Gold Mine, so we expected that we would find natural gold there. This is no real big surprise, but the fact that we did, and that I can show it to you guys, and that we can complete the mineral scan from how to do it in the field, how to bring the scan over to the laptop, and then how to analyze the scan in your with your Visualizer 3D software. I mean, this is one of the trickiest parts of the mineral scan, is actually being able to go in and, you know, find that natural gold. You don't find it all the time, but when you do find it, it's super exciting. And this is a great example of a hit in a hit at the Reed Gold Mine. So take a look at this. Learn from it. If you have any questions, you know how to reach us. But this is a great example of a hit in a hit at the Reed Gold Mine. This is really cool. Thanks a lot.